Hey guys, oh, man, I'm so ready today. Oh, yeah, let's just go ahead and put in the turnaround state.
Turnaround mode selected.
Yeah, I don't know what that is. Just wanna get that in there. Yeah, yeah, we're using the rad variant today. The one that I use to transport the beam. So let's load her on up. There won't be many today, apparently. Let's use probably like 5. That was unexpected.
Los Angeles Airport information off.
FlybyWire field. It's a field that you can only get for a download. You have to have the map and all that stuff. You have to have that stuff. If you don't have it, then it just doesn't work. I don't even know why. The map charts don't have that today. Take off the 24-hour clock. It doesn't save, so kind of annoying. It is 6:18 right now. Zulu time, I think it's 8:18. That's Zulu time. And yeah, this is pretty neat out here. Everything is green. That's good. It's only on the 100. That's why. I've been trying to figure out why there's no 18 burials on that. Other things. See those guys right there? Watch them. It's on turnaround, obviously. It sometimes gets pretty laggy. I always turn off the power, so it doesn't go bad. But, let's just turn it off. Yeah, just turn it off for a minute. Going to turn on our PTU. Get the green pump. It should start rolling. And the reason why last time we had to go for a different version is because our gear didn't come up. And there's one reason for that is because of the hydraulic pressure. What is watch doing? That's kind of what I thought, nothing. Alright, let's go ahead and get these engines started. Let's go ahead and power up the GPU. So power set pretty fast, so nothing will work. We're going to start with number 1 today. No, number 4, since people are coming in on the...
Los Angeles clearance delivery, generic Juliet Mike Echo, 613 Golf IFR, to Luton, ready to copy.
Is that us? I think that might be us.
Generic Juliet Mike Echo, 613 Golf, is cleared to Luton Airport as filed. Takeoff runway, 25 right, climb and maintain 10,000 feet. Departure frequency is 134.75 squawk 5256.
Well, let's go ahead and start it up. Yeah, I don't know what happened to start power. It just doesn't work after the APU starts. I don't know if it's a certain thing that the APU does when it starts.
Generic Juliet Mike Echo, 613 Golf, cleared to Luton Airport as filed. Takeoff runway, 25 right, climb and maintain 10,000 feet. Departure on 134.75 squawk 5256. Generic 13 Golf readback is correct. contact ground on 131.975 when ready to taxi. Good day.
How are we, I think I might be on ground. Sorry about that. I'm going to be on ground when I'm on, air traffic control, and I don't want air traffic control at, like, at all. I think I'm on tower. Now I'm on tower. So I won't get anything when I'm on ground, so just do like that. Just go ahead and try to figure out why this doesn't happen. But yeah, you can. Okay, the pack should be off, the APU air all off. You know what, I'm just followed by checklist today, because I ain't trying to mess anything up. Now let's go ahead and put empty and cold.
Cold and dark selected.
Alright, let's go. Let's go ahead and get out our fresh checklist. Some of the stuff I don't know where it is, and doesn't tell me where it is, like on the Concorde, or like if you press the button, it'll tell you where it is.
Landing gear.
Down.
Down.
Some indigo space.
Weather radar.
Off and 15 degrees up. This might take a while. I think we should be facing up 15.
Off and 15 degrees up. Transponder. STBY.
Oh, sorry, I'll sit by.
Air brake and flaps. In and up. NAV lights.
I'll be right back. Back. So let's go ahead and do what we were doing. I did put in turnaround on the first, so that's why I'm trying to figure out why.
High int. That one and two.
I turned them off. It's something, when it says start power on, you just gotta go start it for some reason. Got it turned.
Both on voltage checked. Parking brake. Yellow and park. Master switches.
Where are the master switches? Oh, wait, it's actually showing me. Actually showing me where it was.
All on. Okay. Anti-skid.
See, like, it showed it for some reason.
On. Lift spoliers yellow and green.
Now where is that supposed to be? Let's see if it's showing me today. That's probably gone. Oh, they could definitely do a bit better on this. Oh yeah, they could definitely do a bit better on that. I don't know if it was like, look at this. That's better, but it's not. Well, I guess it can't really do anything. Here, talk about it. The spoilers, yellow and. But you know what? That is the exact reason why my spoilers aren't here. Pause this. Do all this.
Los Angeles ground, stay west tree 463, requesting pushback. Stay west tree 463 pushback request accepted.
That's what happens when you're on ground. Stable is stabilizing. Like, it's, when it comes to that, I just, see, you guys saw how the start power went off, right? All these should be on. There's no way I'm going to be able to start my engines without that happening. I just can't start. Alright, it's stable about 100. opposite RPM. Wait. You turn down some of the stuff for us. Okay. Both on. Oh. Alright, let's do the restore. I'm not gonna do all the
departure briefing.
Well, at least try.
Complete.
Los Angeles ground,
brake pressure.
463, requesting
check above 2500 psi.
SkyWest Tree 463 request to end pushback received.
All off.
You have to turn that on.
Fuel center transfer.
Auto, okay.
Auto. Ice detect.
There's ice detect. Sometimes I don't, and I don't like how it.
On.
I don't like how.
Fasten seatbelt signs.
But you have to know, you really know this plane well.
On. Fuel quantity.
Like sometimes it shows up and sometimes it doesn't. Alright. Fuel quantity, it should give us enough to go to the flybyware.
Checked. Altimeters.
I'm going ADIS to see what the, not the millibars, but... I forgot what that was called. So, I'm going ADIS. Oh wait, sorry, ADIS. Let's go and turn on ADIS. Yeah, it's altimeter. Yeah, the altimeter is 2.99, so we're close. How many do you have to check? I think you have a lot that I have to check. I have two. This guy has one, so let's go ahead.
Set cross-checked. MWS GRD OP switch. Reset red light extinguished. TMS/N1/ speed bugs.
Yeah, that one's, you have to turn on the power. Then you gotta go test it. There we go. Test is in operation. Now what you have to do is, so takeoff, this is our takeoff speed, 93. I guess we can do it for today, because I don't really, yeah, alright, in one. Kinda goes back sometimes for some reason. I don't know how that happens. But I'm just pronouncing. I don't feel like doing them all. And I'm definitely not doing them. So what, 93% is what it was? Wait, hold on, let me check the make temperature. Because that's usually about right. It's 18 degrees Celsius. There's also outside air temperature that tests too. That's in Fahrenheit. I'm gonna head control 3 so I can see if it better up. Toga! Yep, that's good. So we're just gonna put it on sync, and then we do the sync. It's all gonna be synced on one. I'm gonna put the sync, but it might work. just call me on 1, that's number 1, because I already set it for the speed bump heading. So, are you going? Yeah, I think it might work. Right now it's like that, but this blows me off soon. I think it can. Yeah, it's just, there we go. Alright. Oh, you can also do this. Oh, yeah, perfectly sets everything. Totally forgot to do that. Okay, I'm just gonna stop that one. Is it? That one doesn't work for some reason.
Doors and equipment. Closed and removed.
Let's just go tell the team that now we know that we've been waiting for a while. But Queen Elizabeth, this we are really sorry for the wait. We will go ahead and get moving shortly and the engines will start up. Thank you very much for your patience. That's like my best British voice I can do. Okay, starting power is on. And once we get in the air, I'm trying to take continuous ignition because in the 146-200, my engines failed. It just said, I just got a red warning light. No, I didn't know what happened, no, nothing. Okay, I don't know why you need to turn on anti-ice for this. It's like, I guess you could since it's like 64 degrees, but that's really unnecessary. PMS. I don't know how to turn off the CMS. Oh, there you go. That's easy. That was really easy. Alright, we can start 4. Alright. Already have inland rotors. That's how fast these engine fan blades go. Alright, let's see if it's 20 and 1, or is it 22? I'm gonna do 22. Go ahead and release it. You are now free. I was making sure that all these, everything looks right before starting. But my fuel pumps may not be on.
Fuel pumps. All on.
Yeah, they're all on.
TMS. Off. Engine start power. Norm. Engine start master switch. On. Start select switch. Engine 4. Engine start switch. Start.
Try again.
N2.
Oh. Well, I guess I clearly didn't do something right. Let's start all the way from the beginning. What about that? I want to cut the power so it doesn't take any fuel. So does that kind of mess up the fuel calculations?
Beacon light.
It's like all the way back up here. Like, what's the purpose of putting a beacon
on
back here?
How you put PAX and else? APU air.
All off. Oh, that's why. That's why. APU air should be off. PAX in the air. That's all. And now I gotta do it. PAX. There's like two PAX.
All off.
Right,
engine
to
anti-ice. All
try
4
try
on. N2.
What? Did you seriously try starting it again? Oh, whatever. Oh, the N2 needs to be 10%, and the N2 is 10%. Yes, I don't know how to get into the perfect position. Alright. Hopefully we have some TTT rotation. That's not the only thing that I did that I didn't do before start. So I don't know why it isn't starting. It just starts and then goes back. Yeah, I mean, I'm not the best at flying this. Like, what, I got this yesterday. Alright, it's gonna go die back down, and I'm gonna try to figure out, let's turn off our starter, what about that? Let's turn everything off. have low pressure for now. Alright, let's try this one more time. Or, either, you know what, let's just do it in 3. Alright. Into rotation. In N1. Can't forget about you, N1. It's like, I'm pretty sure there was business to work. Oh, it'll just look right at the throttles. Let's see if we can get a good start. Not starting. Okay. Let's... Okay, fuel, ice protect, rotor valve, parking brake, ignition. Yeah, these really wouldn't affect the engine not starting. Oil pressure is low. That makes sense. Yeah, this is confusing. We have 30 minute flight. King just sent us, we're gonna go see the 1880 and see how it's doing yet. This was like Christmas. She just heard about it and stuff. You know how clean is. Late, I guess. Let's just turn off the engine anti-ice. I just really don't think it's going to be helping us. It's like really not that cold outside. Alright, let's start engine improving. Hydraulics. Yeah, I'm going to check my hydraulics again. Hydraulics are good. AC pump should be auto. AC pump should be on. And yeah, it seems about right. And yeah, here in the morning, P2. Well, this is life. Try turning off the starter. Nothing should be on. Let's turn on generator 4 and generator 1. Yeah, alright. All this stuff is on. Good. Alright, sure. I just want to leave it on because it's kind of confusing. Which one is the view? 5? 6? Oh yeah, 6. That's what it is. That's what it is. 6. Yep, stop starting, so I'm guessing I had to like... look ready for takeoff. That's like the worst thing you can possibly do though. It's like, what are we doing to ready for takeoff and it's gonna take all day to start these daggone engines? We're like, you go faster if you do it. Oh, that's where the lift spoilers are. I'm gonna take on my air brake and see if... I guess it has no oil. Let me just check the oil. But I'm guessing brown. What about that?
Ready for takeoff selected.
But how do you start the engines and I can't? I started them the other day. Well, it's in my question. How is that all? It's going to take a while. I'm gonna see if this guy can start the engines. If he can't start the engines, he needs to hope somebody has a problem with me. And if I can't start the engines, if he can't start the engines, I would say, if I can't start the engines, I can just end it. Yeah, so, here, we got the hydraulics problem. And, top the hydraulics, we got turned on some of that. At least it comes. And he still can't start. Yeah, he can't start. These engines are not starting. Flight recorder's off. Communication is on. Big fans on. True. Parking brake is on. And electric. Oh! Electric. That's what I was on. So, something is wrong with the electric. Looking at the electrics, the only thing I see bad here is the generators. I was trying to save the generator, see if that works. I don't know if it pops back or anything. This is like, Control E couldn't start it, I couldn't start it, and the guy who like made the states couldn't start it. That's a problem. That's a problem with the whole plane. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and skip being what is this? It's been an hour? This plane's still acting up. Yep, travel forward in time. I don't know what's wrong with that plane, guys. The plane just didn't start. It needs a really good, probably needs a really good overhaul with its engines. I didn't try engine 1 and 2. 3 and 4, we just messed up. I didn't try, I think it might be the generators. We want to figure out what happened. The hydraulics were good, electric was super good. Really, generator 1 and 4 were offline. I don't know if that's recommended. I mean, it's supposed to be there for a new start. April, they waited all the way until May. It's 2 years.
Angeles Tower JDF B4068 ready for departure to the west at runway 25 right.
Let's test some stuff real quick before we start. Did I test anything? Okay. All of the containers work good. There are no failures in this aircraft. Unless you have really good one. You have one. That's just this side. Moose. Moose. Oh. Yeah, my cat's still here. You try going where my mouse pad is. I'm not testing the last time today. Yeah, I'm gonna just dump it out. Yeah, I'm fine with that, because we sat in there pretty long. I just control lock off. Alright, okay, so I do remember it being locked before it's good. Alright, let's go ahead and give this a good bit.
Speed alive, both sides.
Speed alive, both sides.
80 knots, cross-checked.
Right. Yeah, we do have some noises. I mean, the
V1. Rotate.
Both sides, ETA.
V2.
Alright, we're lifting off the base systems.
Positive rate of climb, gear up.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we're supposed to turn on the
FTO, safe height speed, select flap top.
Bank angle.
This looks so take off some rails. Find some rails. Come in. I'll shut all down stuff. And I'll put two of them on some rails. So it's sort of like a real flight. Except I'm the same captain. And also sometimes it's the same captain. And it's two flights. So I'll have to go. It's not one way. It's two stops. So I'm going to take it back to the house, I guess. 5 minutes on the simulator. I don't know if I'll make it. The FlybyWire. But if I do, I know what. That's a lot of flames to load.
Sink rate. Autopilot disconnected. Bank angle.
Pull up. 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 Pull up.
500.
See. 80 knots. 60 knots.